إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. قال الله عز وجل: فاذكروني أذكركم. وقال تعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم. وقال تعالى: ومن كان في هذه أعمى فهو في الآخرة أعمى وأضل سبيلا. وثبت عن الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه قال: احفظ الله يحفظك. وفي حديث قدسي أن الله عز وجل قال: من ذكرني في نفسه ذكرته في نفسي، وما ذكرني في ملأ ذكرته في ملأ خير منهم. These verses and these authentic hadith are from much of Adilla in Quran and Sunnah, which are proof for that famous principle. An important fundamental in Islam, which is al-jaza'u min jinsi al-amal. The reward is based on the action. The reward or the punishment, what you receive is based on the action you do. So whoever does good gets good reward. Whoever does better gets better reward. قال تعالى سبحانه وتعالى: ولله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض ليجزي الذين أساءوا بما عملوا ويجزي الذين أحسنوا بالحسنى. Those who do إحسان, righteousness, Allah سبحانه وتعالى rewards them with righteousness, with حسنى. And the opposite, وَجَزَاءُ سَيِّئَةٍ سَيِّئَةٌ مِثْلُهَا. ثُمَّ كَانَ عَاقِبَةَ الَّذِينَ أَسَاءُ السُّوءَ أَنْ كَذَّبُوا. ثُمَّ كَانَ عَاقِبَةَ الَّذِينَ أَسَاءَ السُّوءَ. So the person only earns, only gets and receives as reward based on what he earned with his hands, with his tongue, with his heart, with his limbs. Therefore Allah says, Subhana fadhkuruni adhkurkum, remember me, mention me to remember you. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu in tansurullaha yansurkum. O you believe, if you make nasr for Allah, aid Allah Azza wa Jal, support Allah, means fulfill His commands. Yansurkum, Allah aids you, support you, assist you, help you. The same thing you do is the reward you get. So, this qa'ida, al-jaza'u min jinsi al-amal, the reward of basin of the action, is from sunanullah fi khalqi, from the ways of Allah to govern subhanahu wa ta'ala his creation. Sunnat Allah allati qad khalat min qabl wa lan tajida li sunnati llahi tabdila. Man amila salihan min dhakarin aw untha, qala ta'ala wa man ya'mal su'an yujza bih wa la yajid lahu min dunillahi waliyan wa la nasira. The way of Allah subhanahu is that the person to be rewarded based on his action. in terms of how the person deals with Allah. You remember Allah, Allah remembers you. You assist Allah, which means you obey Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala assists you. You answer the call of Allah, Allah answer your call and accept your dua. وإذا سألك عبادي عني فإني قريب أجيب دعوة الداعي إذا دعان فليستجيبوا لي. The more you obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you answer his call azza wa jal, is the closer Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala answer your call. احفظ الله يحفظ. So if you love the meat of Allah, to meet Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves you to meet with him. Man ahabba liqa'a Allah, ahabba Allahu liqa'a. Authentic hadith. Whoever loves to meet Allah, Allah loves to meet him. Wa man kariha liqa'a Allah, kariha Allahu liqa'a. Whoever dislikes to meet Allah, Allah dislikes to meet him. So, based on how you deal with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Azza wa Jalla deals with you. That's not our topic tonight. The topic tonight is that the way we deal with the people is the way Allah deals with us. This is very important. Especially our time that many Muslims separate between their acts of worship, their prayer, their fasting, their charity, and between how they deal with the creation of Allah. Person, alhamdulillah, in the masjid, good, mashallah, good in charity, good in performing hajj, in performing umrah, alhamdulillah, but deal with him in business. He cheats you, he deceives you. Double standard. You say, this is not the Muslim who I used to know him in the masjid. How is he doing these things? Because we don't understand this principle. That however we deal with the people, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is dealing with us. For instance, if you, as we will mention, the proof for all of it, of what I say inshallah now, from now on, if you make easy for a Muslim, Allah make easy for you. If you help a Muslim, Allah helps you. If you cover a weakness, shortcoming of a Muslim, Allah cover your shortcoming, conceal your weakness. If you expose Muslim's weakness, Allah expose yours. If you accept the excuse of a Muslim, Allah accept yours. If you forgive people, you don't revenge, you don't retaliate, even though you can, you have right for it, but you forgive them, Allah forgives you. If you punish people wrongly, Allah punish you. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you show mercy to the people, Allah shows mercy to you. If you thank people, Allah thanks you. If you don't, Allah don't. Azza wa Jal. Subhanallah. One proof from Quran or from the Sunnah is enough to show that this principle, al-jaza'u min jinsi al-amal, the reward is based on the action, is haq and true. How about if there are many verses and many ahadith? As Imam Ibn al-Qayyim mentioned that all the sharia stands on that principle, al-jaza'u min jinsi al-amal. And Imam Ibn Kathir also mentioned that in his tafsir in Surah An-Nur, in the verse Surah An-Nur, أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ. To mention some of that, the proof of some of those points, so we should know that we will be very watchful. how we're dealing with the people. It's not because you are stronger than him. He has no one behind you. You can deceive him. You can cheat him. You can go on your way, steal his proper talk about his honor, oppress him, and you will be free. La. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who knows everything, is there with his justice subhanahu wa ta'ala to get what you earn. كل نفس بما كسبت رهينة وأن ليس للإنسان إلا ما سعى. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us. An authentic hadith collected by Imam Muslim and Bukhari. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من لا يرحم الناس لا يرحمه الله. من اسم موصول, whoever, whosoever, لا يرحم الناس, doesn't mercy the people, doesn't show mercy to the people, لا يرحمه الله, Allah doesn't show mercy to him. If you are not kind to the people, you don't show mercy to them, don't expect that from Allah either. Because Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, من لا يرحم الناس لا يرحمه الله, collected by Imam Bukhari and Muslim. In another hadith narrated by جرير بن عبد الله بن عبد الله البجلي رضي الله عنهما, he said, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إنما يرحم الله من عباده الرحماء, أخرجه الطبراني بسند حسن, review صحيح الجامع 2381. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, innama yarhamullah, innama adatu hasrin wa qasrin. Only Allah mercies, only Allah shows mercy to who? From his servants, ar-ruhama, the mercy ones, the merciful ones. Only Allah shows mercy from his servants to those who are ruhama, jam'u rahim, they show mercy. In another hadith, collected by reported by Hadith Sahih Sahih al-Jami' 3522 from Amr Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As radiyallahu anhuma, and Shaykh al-Albani said this hadith sahih. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, irhamu man fil ardi yarhamkum man fis sama, irhamu man fil ard, show mercy to the one who is on the earth, يَرْحَمْكُمْ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاءِ, to have mercy on you, the one who is in the heaven. مَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ, general, whoever on the earth, no exclusive, whoever, for human being, Muslim, non-Muslim, animal, anyone, show mercy. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was saying, as mercy to all the creation, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. Even when you are slaughtering in the goat, Prophet ﷺ commands to slaughter in a nice way, to sharpen your knife, to do it in a proper way, in a soft way, in the fastest way, not to oppress the animal, not to lower that which it can't carry, to give it its right, and the like. So whoever show mercy to the one who is on the earth, يَرْحَمْكُمْ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاءِ, to have mercy on you, the one who is in the heaven, means Allah. This is hadith about the mercy. So if you don't mercy to the people, you don't show them mercy, you are not kind to them, then no, الْجَزَاءُ مِنْ جِنْسِ الْعَمَلِ. Don't surprise if you don't get the mercy of Allah. In another hadith collected by Imam Muslim, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَنْ نَفَّسَ عَنْ مُؤْمِنٍ كُرْبَةً مِنْ كُرَبِ الدُّنْيَا نَفَّسَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ كُرْبَةً مِنْ كُرَبِ يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. Whoever relieves the stress from a Muslim, from a believer, from worldly distress, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala relieves him distress, one of the distress and the difficulties of the day of judgment. In the day of judgment, a lot of distressful things. Starting from the grave. لَأَنَّ الْقَبْرَ أَوَّلُ مَنَازِلِ الْآخِرَةِ The grave is the first position of the hereafter. So from when you are in the grave till the day of judgment, there are a lot of difficulties and hardships, problems, calamities, griefs. If you relieve a Muslim, a believer who is in a difficulty, who is in a state of distress, worry, whatever it may be, until he feel happy, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala in return, thank you for that, and he subhanahu wa ta'ala relieves from you one of the difficulties, one of the stressful things in the hereafter. وَمَنْ يَسَّرَ عَلَى مُعْسِرٍ يَسَّرَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ And whoever makes it easy for a Muslim who is in a difficulty, Allah makes it easy for him in this worldly life and in the hereafter. مُعْسِر, like someone borrow money from you. يعني someone borrow money, borrow something from someone, you came to know he can't pay it. It's either you who lended him or someone else came to know that there's a debt on this person and he can't pay, and you make it easy for him. How much you owe them? 1,000. Yes, I paid $300 or $500 or all of it. And this Muslim, he feel happy. Jazakallah khair. I was worried about what are you bringing. Or is it the one who lended him? Akhi, I don't have it. I am trying. Don't worry about it. Why are you doing that? You want Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to make easy for you when you are in a state of difficult in this life or in the hereafter. Not showing off, not that person to pay you back. You have no interest in that. But because you want Allah to reward you subhanahu wa ta'ala with your good action. Prophet ﷺ continues saying, وَمَنْ سَتَّرَ مُسْلِمًا سَتَّرَهُ اللَّهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ And whoever conceal a false, error, a mistake, shortcoming of a believer, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala conceals, covers his faults in this life and the hereafter. Wallahu fi awni al-abdi ma kana al-abdu fi awni akhi. Allah is helping the slave as long the slave is helping his brother. Allah is at help, is helping. في عون العبد Allah is helping the slave as long the slave is helping his brother. So as long you helping your brother, you helping your sister, it should be known brother, brother, brother. In Islam it also means sisters. Everything said about male in Islam is being said also in the female, unless there is a specific proof which separate that from that, because male and female are not equal in everywhere. There are issues, they're different, because the way Allah created them is different. But the origin and the rule is, whatever is said of commands, responsibilities, rewards, punishments for a male is also for a female. So whenever you hear whoever help his brother, don't expect his sister every time. This is the same in Islam. النساء شقائق الرجال Prophet Sallam said. So the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, والله في عون العبد ما كان العبد في عون أخي. Allah Subhanah is helping the person, the slave, as long the person is helping his brother. Who is not in need of the help of Allah. And should be known. We don't understand, we don't perceive many times how Allah is helping you. Many times you do not know it. Nor do we know how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala azza wa jal is making our affairs difficult. We don't know that. But that's promise. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't forgive. As you know in Surah Al-Kahf, even Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala azza wa jal take care one offspring. Even after that person died. وَكَانَ أَبُوهُمَا صَالِحًا even after you die, let alone while you are alive, if you are in a state of righteousness, you deal with Allah Azza wa Jal the way you should, obeying Him, Subhanah, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, even take care of your offspring in the future because of what you did of good. This hadith is long hadith. وَمَنْ سَلَكَ طَرِيقًا يَلْتَمِسُ فِيهِ عِلْمًا سَهَلَ اللَّهُ لَهُ طَرِيقًا إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ. And whoever takes a path seeking a knowledge, meaning Quran and Sunnah, he want to learn the deen of Allah, to follow it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes him take the path to Jannah. Al-jazaw min jinsi al-amal. The same hadith. وَمَا اجْتَمَعَ قَوْمٌ فِي بَيْتٍ مِنْ بُيُوتِ اللَّهِ يَتْلُونَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ وَيَتَدَارَسُونَ فِيمَا بَيْنَهُمْ إِلَّا نَزَلَتْ عَلَيْهِمُ السَّكِينَةُ وَغَشِيَتْهُمُ الرَّحْمَةُ وَحَفَتْهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ وَذَكَرَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِيمَنْ عِنْدَهُ. الْجَزَاءُ مِنْ جِنْسِ الْعَمَلِ. The same hadith. No group ever gathered in one of the house of Allah, reciting the book of Allah, teaching one another. The angels of Allah surround them, mercy cover them, sakina descend on them. وَذَكَرَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي مَنْ عِنْدَهُ. Allah mentioned about them to those who are with Him. Those people who gather for the sake of Allah, remembering Allah, learning the Sharia of Allah, sending salah and salam to His beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala thanks them by mentioning them to those who are with Him, the special creation of Allah, like the angels who carry the throne of Allah Azza wa Jal. So, وَمَنْ بَطَّأَ بِهِ عَمَلُهُ لَمْ يُسْرِعْ بِهِ نَسَبُهُ. يعني, someone who his actions do not promote him, elevate him, do not give him high level, do not honor him, his lineage will not do anything for him. It's not where you're born and how you're born and how you look like. It's your action. It's from the justice of Allah. From the ways of Allah to deal with His creation is justice. He look at their actions, subhanahu wa ta'ala, azza wa jal, and deal with, not their image and their shape and their origin. In another hadith, hadith Hisham bin Hakim, حديث هشام بن حكيم collected by Imam Muslim في صحيحه رضي الله تعالى عنه said, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إن الله تعالى يعذب يوم القيامة الذين يعذبون الناس في الدنيا لا إله إلا الله لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. إن الله تعالى الله الميري يعذب يوم القيامة punishes in the day of judgment الذين يعذبون الناس, those who punish people في الدنيا, in the worldly life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punishes in the hereafter those who punish people in this worldly life. You torture people in this worldly life, Allah is torturing you in the hereafter. وَلَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوتَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. Some people, some of those who are in a jail or outside the jail, they torture the prisoners, they torture the people. They should wait, and they should have, should know that with the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is torturing them. The same thing they did. So if this is the case, how then the believer is be very eager, how the believer will punish people wrongly, how a believer will oppress people, how a believer, because he knows it will go back to him. It will go back to him. It will not go anywhere else. In another hadith, hadith Abu Huraira, Shaykh al-Albani said sahih, collected by Imam Abu Dawood, Ibn Majah. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, man aqala musliman aqala Allahu athratahu. Man aqala musliman aqala Allahu athratahu. Whoever accepted from a Muslim to cancel the transition. يعني الله سبحانه وتعالى accept his excuse, which means يعني for instance a Muslim buy something from you, he buy a car from you, material from you, a cloth from you, a food from you. Okay? Then he get back to you. He said, Ya Akhi, I mistake, Ya Akhi, to buy this. I found out I shouldn't. I really want to return it. Yes, you have right if there is no weakness. And he already departed the place. There is no khiyarul majlis. There is no khiyarul aib. And he didn't have a condition to come back to you. Certain time. There is no khiyar al-shart. No, all these conditions, options he would have. All that is finished. No deficiency in it. In the merchant. But he the one who hasted. He the one who thought something. Maybe he found another one better than it, which he needed. Maybe he looked for that stuff, he couldn't find it. Then he said, get close to it. And then when he buy from you, he found the exact material he needed. So he doesn't want. So what should you do? The one who accept that person's return, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala azza wa jal does the same for him. So it's not, I don't care him. Since this is what you buy, you grow everything, no deficiency, yes. You can say that. This is haqq. You don't commit a sin. You don't oppress anybody. But what's more better? To be nice to that person, to make easy for him. Because he mistake. Accept. Some people, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. They tell you how you mistake. How can you mistake in these things? You don't mistake the like of these things. How come you don't mistake? And you're a human being. You mistake in business, you mistake in arfais, you mistake in all your amars. Kullukum khata. Wa khayrul khata'in at-tawwabun. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, all of you man, all son of Adam, all of you mistake. But the best of those who mistake are those who return. So to accept the mistake, as long as there is no negligence in it, this mistake is really a mistake. It's not someone who did this intentionally and he claimed he mistake. Now this has a consequence. But if you find this one he mistake, he is from those who hasten. Subhanallah, Allah created man different way. Some people, they have that character of hastening. Hastening. So if you found this person is in that situation, you accept his يعني عثرته. In another hadith collected by Imam Muslim, حديث عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها مسنجر محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم make دعاء Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم make دعاء he asked Allah something he said اللهم من ولي من أمر أمتي شيئا فشق عليهم فاشقق عليه ومن ولي من أمر أمتي شيئا فرافق بهم فارفق به Oh my Lord, Oh Allah, whoever become in charge of one of the mars of my ummah. He become a ruler. He become a responsible person in charge of it. On an issue. And a matter of the mars of my ummah. He become a head of something. You become a manager. You become a leader. You become a head of a company. You become a head of a school. You become a governor. Head of something. Na'am, which people are in need of you. Yes. فَشَقَّ عَلَيْهِمْ فَشْقُقْ عَلَيْهِ Who makes it difficult to them, or Allah make difficult to him. وَمَا وَلِيَ مِنْ أُمَّةِ مِنْ أَمْرِ أُمَّةِ شَيْئًا فَرَفِقَ بِهِمْ فَرْفُقْ بِهِ Oh Allah, whoever become in charge of from the mars of my ummah and makes it easy for them, or Allah make easy for him. Dua of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is al-jaza min jins al-amal. So whoever become in charge of something, ruler, some people when they become leaders, they close their door against your face. Even they deny you. I never know you. How you don't know me? We grow up in the same place. We graduate from the same school. We're still the same neighbor. Since you have security guard and those you forget about me, say I don't know you. La. be easy to him. Naam, you are those who accepted the applications for the company to hire people. Be easy for the people. Yes, you have to follow the requirements, but easy, be easy to them. You are those who set the rules. Don't make these rules difficult to the people. Make it easy rules, which still the benefit can be reached. It's just a general, any issue. Man amri ummati shay'an nakira. So it's general. Anyone who become in charge of something, make people easy for them, Allah make easy for them. Make people difficult to them, Allah makes difficult to them. Another hadith, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, this hadith also collected by Imam Ahmad Abu Dawud, sahih. Shaykh al-Albani said sahih. La yashkuru Allah, man la yashkuru nas. Look, the brothers and sisters in Islam, the reward is based on the action. If you mercy, you get mercy. If you make things difficult to the people, you expect the difficulty. If you provide people, you expect provision. If you cover people, you expect to be cover your weakness. The same thing. Then we choose what we want for ourselves. كما تدين وتدان اعمل لنفسك ما شئت واختارها لما شئت. The way you deal with the people you will be deal with. So choose for yourself what you want. لا إله إلا أن هذا من عدل الله العظيم العادل. This is from the justice of Allah. نعم. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, حديث أبو هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه, لا يشكر الله من لا يشكر الناس. Allah سبحانه وتعالى doesn't thank the one who doesn't thank people. لا يشكر الله. Allah doesn't thank. Allah is not grateful. Allah is not thankful to who? من لا يشكر الناس, the one who is not thankful to the people. People do in favor for you. Your mother is taking care of you. Your father is suffering for you. Your relative, your aunt, your uncle, your husband, your wife, your friend, your neighbor, your teacher, your student. Someone is doing mada good for you. And you are not thanking him. Allah is not thanking you. Allah will not thank you. What does that mean? Al-Imam al-Khattabi said it may mean two things. The one who doesn't thank people. Balla yashkurunas. The one who doesn't thank people. Allah doesn't thank. Subhana, the person who doesn't thank people. It means one of two. Or both. The one who doesn't thank the people, Allah doesn't accept his thanking to him. And here there is someone who doesn't thank people when they do favor for him. He doesn't appreciate. He ignore, he neglect. It's like you didn't never help him. Rather, some of them, wallahi, some people say, لا تعمل الخير لا يأتيك الشر. Some people reach that position. They say, don't do good. You will not have a problem. You know what they mean? They mean some people, if you help them, you suffer. Some people, if you help them, you suffer. You rather not to help them. Why? Because they harm you. They harm you. Imagine someone who come to your house, poor Muslim. He ask you, and you gave him what you have, $10, and he throw the money to you. He said, go, you stingy. Why are you doing that, ya akhi? I have $10, I give it to you. Either you say, Jazakallahu khairan, at least. No, some of them make fun of you. Some of them say bad statement to you. La. So, the person who doesn't thank people for what they do, Allah doesn't accept from him to thank Allah. So whatsoever you do of good, of ibadat, of salah, Allah is not thanking it for you. Why? Because you don't thank the people when they do favor for you. Allah is not accepting your favor, your righteous actions. Also, There is another hadith, من لا يشكر الناس لا يشكر الله. The one who doesn't thank people, he doesn't thank Allah. The one who doesn't thank people, he doesn't also thank Allah. The ulama, they say, means the one who his character, his way of life is not to thank people, to neglect their rights. He is doing the same with Allah Azza wa Jal. So if you find yourself, ya akhi, people are good, doing good for you, but you don't feel, you don't thank them, know that you are not thanking Allah either. Don't expect that you are thanking Allah. Naam. So here all these adilla we know, yani this mar is from a religion of Allah. It's not there is separation between your acts of worship of Allah Azza wa Jal, your ibadat, your salah, and your way of dealing of the, with the people. Two separate issues. Now it's connected. If you say, I'm going to be good in the masjid, for instance, but when I am outside, I have another life, I have another way to deal with the people, don't think that way. The way you deal with the people out there is the same way Allah is dealing with you in the masjid. That thing comes back to you. Remember that female, many times I mentioned that hadith, because every one of us needs to be reminded. That female who they mentioned, or the Messenger of Allah, such female, she prays the night, she fasts the day, تصوم تقوم الليل وتصوم النهار وتتصدق. She gives charity. وتفعل وتفعل. She does. They praise her. But she harm her neighbor with her tongue. ولكنها تؤذي جارها بلسانها. And what is the rule of that? Oh, the Messenger of Allah. A woman, not only she established the mandatory prayer, not only she fasted the mandatory fasting, not only she gives them obligation, the mandatory jarid, but also the optional. Struggle in ibadat, qiyamul layl, tahajjud, sawm. Masha Allah. When you see her, alhamdulillah. But she has here another issue. She harmed the people with her tongue. Prophet said, لا خير فيها هي في النار. Nothing good is in her. She's in hellfire. They also mention another female in the same hadith, who are the Messenger of Allah. They mention that she only does the mandatories. She only does the prayer, the mandatory prayer, the mandatory fasting, the mandatory charity. Not optional like the first one. But she doesn't harm anyone. Prophet said here fil Jannah, she's in the paradise. Shaykh al-Albani authenticated that hadith. After hearing this hadith and the like of it, can we ignore the people? And we think, well, let we do what we wanna, let we deal the way we wanna we deal with them. We deceive them in business, we deceive them in, we really deceiving ourselves. But sometimes we don't know it. ولكنهم لا يشعرون. They don't feel it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala azza wa jal remember that beautiful story, even though we don't take lesson from it, especially for the female or wives of the Muslimin, listen for your favor. Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam brought his wife and his young baby born Ismail that time in Mecca with no life. And then he went back to where he came from because Allah commanded that. Then Prophet Ismail survived. Allah brought the water of Zamzam. And he get married after time. Then Prophet Ibrahim one day came to the house while Prophet Ismail was not there, but his wife was there. And she doesn't know Prophet Ibrahim. He asked her, how their life is. She mentioned that they are in shiddah wadiq. They are in difficulty. They have in a difficulty. The life they have don't suffice them. Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam told her to convey to her husband Ismail this word, غير عتبت بابك. Change the wood which is before the entrance, at the entrance of your door. In the entrance of the door there is wood. Some houses there is a metal, maybe Allahu Alam, like a stairway, Allahu Alam. Anyway, let him change that wood, that object. Fixes? Doorstep. Jazakallahu khair, Ismail. She didn't understand what that means. But there's an old man who conveyed that message. She conveyed as it is. Very amana to Prophet Ismail. He said, how he look like such and such. He said, that's my father. And he commanded me to divorce you. Al-hiqi bi ahlik. So go to your family. She's divorced. Prophet Ismail knows Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. The Imam of Khair. He's not commanding him wrong thing. He's not commanding him oppression. Rather justice and adl. And likewise, any justice father, justice mother, upon haq who advise her son, her daughter, should listen. But very father, but very make sure that there is haq, clear haq. Umar bin al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu command his son, Ibn Umar, to divorce his wife. Umar is authentic. And then Ibn Umar, he mentioned that to the Prophet ﷺ, because Ibn Umar loved his wife. Prophet ﷺ said, "Ati abak, obey your father." One man came to Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal. He said, "Oh, Imam Ahmad," he said, "he loves his wife, but his father is telling him to divorce his wife." Imam Ahmad said, "Keep your wife." He said, "But Imam Ahmad, Umar bin Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu command his son Ibn Umar to divorce, and Prophet sallam told Ibn Umar to obey his father. What do I do with this?" He said, "Hatta yakuna abuka mithlu Umar." Wait till your father become like Umar. Yes, so every father's command in this issue is not being accepted. Yes, the father will be respected, but the issue will be, look, if this woman is corrupting this man's religion, she is corrupting him, and the father find out, and this is a proof there, the son shouldn't follow his desire. Naam. So, Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, Ismail divorced that wife, that woman. He married another one. Again, after time, Prophet Ibrahim came to the same house, to the house of Ismail, and asked, now another woman, how is your wife? She said, good. Alhamdulillah. Athnat ala Allah khair. She praised Allah and she said, good. We be khair. We good. Alhamdulillah. No demands, no complaints. Then Prophet Ibrahim gave this message, how to convey to her husband Ismail alayhi salam. He said, يُثَبِّتُ عَتَبَةَ بَابِهِ. Tell him to firm the ataba of his door, to keep it. Now what happened to this woman? This is the point. She complained. What happened to her? Allah caused Prophet Ibrahim to complain about her. Did you understand that? She complained about her husband without haq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made Prophet Ibrahim to complain about her. She complained about her husband, Prophet Ibrahim complained about her. This one, she praised her husband, Prophet Ibrahim praised her. Al-jazaa'u bi jinsi al-amal. So, many women, regardless how their husband struggle, how he is honest, how he trying, they are ungrateful to them. As the Prophet ﷺ mentioned, he said, oh woman, give a lot of charity, give charity. Save yourself from hellfire. Give charity. Why? Because of your kufr, negligence to the right of your one of you, her husband will do this, this, and one day something happened. She said, you never did anything for me. You never did anything for me. So, yani also, yaakhi, too much complaint, too much demand, too much complaint. Allah is one who suffices. Alhamdulillah. Al-qana'ah, al-ghina, ghina nafs. The richness is the richness of the soul. Sometimes you may be financially poor. Your income is very low. But alhamdulillah, you're happy with it. Alhamdulillah. Prophet ﷺ had nothing to eat sometimes, nothing to drink sometimes. Sahaba used to sometimes eat the leaves of the tree. They never left their religion. Today you have someone, a little shortage, even doubt about his religion. He started eating haram. What's the problem? Is weakness of iman or lack of iman. We ask Allah to forgive us. Also in another hadith, authentic hadith, Prophet ﷺ said, Allah Azza wa Jalla said, Ya Ibn Adam, anfiq unfiq alayk. Ya Ibn Adam, anfiq unfiq alayk. Or kama qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, oh, the son of Adam, spend, means to the people, to be spender to. Spend out, provide, give from your wealth to the needy, to be spended when you are in need. Another hadith, Allah Azza wa Jalla said to the kingship, أَمَا تَرْضَيْنَا أَنْ أَصِلَ مَنْ وَصَلَكَ وَأَقْطَعَ مَنْ قَطَعَكَ فَذَلِكَ لَكِ. Collected by Bukhari Muslim. The kinship, whoever connected the kinship, the ties of kinship, the relative, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala connects him. Whoever cut them off, Allah cuts him off. Collected by Bukhari and Muslim. One of the Sahaba, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, was from those who mistakenly believe what the hypocrites spread against our mother Aisha, the wife of the Prophet. So he was from those who talk about her, who said, yes, she did this. Until Allah revealed the revelation, subhanahu wa ta'ala, as in Surah An-Nur, making clear that our mother Aisha, radiallahu ta'ala anha, is free from that. And those who initiated that are the enemy of Allah. And those who are not the enemy of Allah, but involve that spread, what has been spread by the enemy of Allah, also have a share. From those was this great Sahabi, Mustah radiallahu ta'ala, and who was a relative of the Prophet, who was Muhajir, who was a poor. And Abu Bakr used to take care of him, provide him. But this happened. Sometimes people, they spread lies, and some good Muslims, they believe it. Especially if you heard from someone who you trust. But ya akhi, the one you trust is a human being. He can mistake. Regardless how great Sheikh he is, Mustah, the Sahabi, is greater than any scholar who came after him. But it is a human being. This is life. Proof that a human being can mistake. The Sahabi Mustah radiallahu ta'ala anhu mistake in this issue. And he was lashed for that. So then Abu Huraira, Abu Bakr, the father of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, he swear by Allah that he will stop helping Madam Mustah. How are you doing this? I am his helping him, I'm his relative, and also talking about my daughter, the wife of Prophet, saying this, I will not. He swear by Allah. Allah reveal ayah in Surah An-Nur. وَلَا يَأْتَلِي أُولُو الْفَضْلِ مِنْكُمْ وَالسَّعَةِ أَنْ يُؤْتُوا أُولِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْمَسَاكِينَ وَالْمُهَاجِرِينَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَلْيَعْفُوا وَلْيَصْفَحُوا أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbade those who are helping the poor, the muhajir, the relative, to swear by Allah that they will not. Allah said, أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ. Don't you love Allah to forgive you? This is the point. When you are not, oh Abu Bakr, radiallahu ta'ala, when you are not forgiven, mister, or this al-ibra bi'umum al-lafzi la bi-khusus al-sabu, the consideration is not the cause of the verse, rather is the meaning. So whoever has someone wronged him and doesn't want to forgive, he want to revenge. Don't you want Allah to forgive you? Don't you have shortcoming? Doesn't it happen you wrong Allah Azza wa Jal? Doesn't it happen you wrong people? And what we may not know may be way much more than what we know it. Don't think if you don't know you wrong somebody, that's the case all the time. We may not know it. And for sure we wrong in Allah Azza wa Jal. We didn't do the right of Allah. We didn't fulfill what we should. No doubt. So don't you want to be forgiven? Allah said, أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ. Don't you love that Allah forgives you? Abu Bakr said, نعم. Yes, oh Allah. He changed. Abu Bakr, he changed his decision. He made expiation. He continued doing for mistah, whatever he used to do. Simply because Abu Bakr wants forgiveness from Allah. So, ya akhi, if somebody wrong you, don't all the time till you meet Allah, keep that in your heart. Naam, yani, I will not forgive him. And you have all kinds of malice and envy and hasad. And you enjoy to see the destruction of that person. And maybe sometimes the bad one among us will not only keep that in their heart, in their soul, rather they will talk. He did this, he did this, he did this. They will even use hand to fulfill their envy. La. Take it easy. Do you want Allah to forgive you if you're wrong? Yes, you want. Do the same for the people. If you don't do it, don't expect it. Naam. Final hadith in this, inshallah ta'ala, talk in this matter. Many ahadith. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in authentic hadith, Sana'i'u al-ma'roof taqi masari'a su' wal-afati wal-halakat wa ahlu al-ma'roof fi dunya hum ahlu al-ma'roof fi al-akhirah. Those who are ahlu al-ma'roof, those who do ma'roof, good, help, they do good in this worldly life, are those who deserve good in the hereafter. Ahlu al-ma'roof fi dunya, ahlu al-ma'roof fi al-akhirah. So in akhirah, if you want ma'ruf, if you want a good, do this worldly life good. I conclude with the sha'r poem, which says, فَلَا تَجْزِعَنَّ مِنْ سُنَّةٍ أَنْتَ سِرْتَهَا وَأَوَّلُ رَاضِي سُنَّةٍ مَنْ يَسِيرُهَا. يعني, don't feel bad about a way you initiated it, you took it, which is not to forgive, which is to harm people, which is these things. Don't feel bad if that happened to you. It's you who did it. That's what it means. You the one who did it. If you don't mercy to the people, and your time you don't receive mercy from Allah, you don't receive mercy from people, then feel happy. Don't take it easy. Don't get wild because you did the same to the people. So, Ikhwan, if we look this, we should know what when we're dealing with the people, naam, that's what we're getting. If we make easy, it will be easy for us. Show mercy, we receive mercy. Make it difficult, we get difficult. Kama tadinu to that. Naam. The same thing, yani, if the people, the society are hardship onto the leaders or their rulers, talk about them, backbite them, harsh on them. The rulers are being harsh to them. If they make dua for their rulers, Allah to satisfy, Allah to guide them, Allah to protect them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep them firm. Na'am. And the like, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala make the leaders easy for the people too. Kama tadiru to Dan. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us. We ask Allah to guarantee us righteous actions. Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-afwa wal-afiyah. إنك على كل شيء قدير وصلى الله وسلم وبارك.